Greetings, Fionas and Shreks. This is Mad Hatter Patrick. As a person who watched Christmas movies until the 25th, there are some that don't look like Christmas movies, but often feel like they are.
The biggest examples are movies like Gremlins, Batman Returns, and Die Hard. Around them, they have elements of Christmas, but in the center, they primarily focus on the theme of horror, superheroic action, and exploding action. In fact, I even saw some cartoons that have that holiday vibe, even though they either don't take place on Christmas or don't focus on it a lot. And one of those anime movies that falls into that category is one of DreamWorks' most underrated movies, Rise of the Guardians. Known to be a fairy tale style Avengers film, it was based on a book called The Guardians of Childhood and a short film by William Joyce, starring holiday characters and mystical creatures. But in 2012, while it was well received by many, the box office did not give the film any faith whatsoever. It received $306.9 million worldwide against its $145 million budget. Long story short, it wasn't enough for DreamWorks due to its high production and marketing costs, forcing the studio to take an $83 million write-down. It was also up against the big league movies like Lincoln, Skyfall, it even lost to Twilight Breaking Dawn Part 2. It was the first time since Sinbad the studio lost a huge amount of money. And this film will be the last DreamWorks film to be distributed by Paramount Pictures before moving to 20th Century Fox in 2013, and then Universal in 2019.
Welcome to another episode of The Wonder Reviews. Why am I doing this? Because the moon told me. This is my review of Rise of the Guardians.
The film is about Jack Frost, played by Chris Pine, who was chosen to become a guardian for children all over the world. The reason? Well, apparently there's this man on the moon that selected him to join the crew, featuring the Sandman, the Easter Bunny, played by Hugh Jackman, the Tooth Fairy, played by Isla Fisher, and Santa Claus, played by Alec Baldwin. Together, they had to join forces to defeat the evil boogeyman, voiced by Jude Law, and stop him from spreading fear and darkness everywhere. While most of it is considered an action movie, I'll explain later, they tell the story as a fairy tale. Not only do we see interpretations of how the guardians do their jobs and present their powers like making toys or decorating eggs, but they clarify their purpose in life. Why does Santa deliver gifts on Christmas? Why does the Tooth Fairy collect teeth? Why does the Easter Bunny hide eggs on Easter Sunday? Because all of them are meant to encourage people to believe in themselves in their own special way, such as wonder, dreams, and hope. It also applies to Jack Frost. He has a side plot that connects this entire movie together where he tries to figure out his own identity and why he was chosen. It does have some humor, but they're mostly rare and often visual. The only issue I have with the plot, like most people would, it resembles a bit much like Marvel's The Avengers, where it involves forming a recognizable team to stop a mischievous villain and his army with sometimes team conflict. And I don't fully understand on why the moon is considered the founder of the Guardians and how they communicate with it.
Although the comparisons to the Avengers seems uncanny, it still succeeds as an action anime movie, much like The Incredibles, and that thanks to the charm of the characters.
Starting with the main protagonist, Jack Frost is the new member of the Guardians who is often mischievous, but is trying to figure out why he was selected and what is considered his purpose for bringing snow to everyone. He is also trying to overcome the issue of being invisible to everyone but Pitch and the other Guardians. When it comes to the other heroes of the film, they're actually memorable thanks to their performances and distinct versions of themselves. These include Sandman being the Tinkerbell-esque member of the group, the Easter Bunny is the arrogant tough rabbit and Jack's rival, Tooth is the bubbly and cheerful fairy, and Santa is the leader of the Guardians who is both jolly and intimidating. But the one thing I had to say about this character is that Alec Baldwin's performance as Santa is far better entertaining than his other performances we would get later from DreamWorks. There's also Jamie, the kid who believes in all the Guardians. He's also the most forgettable character of the film since he's there for plot convenience. And finally, you have Pitch Black, aka the Boogeyman, who in my opinion is the most underrated DreamWorks villain. He's pretty much a Hades-style supervillain. He's one with the shadows, and he has an army of nightmare horses that forms a black tidal wave. Plus, he has a diabolical plan on trying to make everyone on Earth forget the Guardians for revenge and spread unprecedented fear for all eternity. Yes, this high production is what made the movie flop, but you gotta give it a lot of credit. This animation does look spectacular. The character designs are well detailed from their distinctive textures. The lighting effects are well put out from the shadows to the moonlight, and the rest present some wonderful visuals from Sandman's Dream Sand to Pigeon's Nightmares to Jack Frost's Snowstaff. With the backgrounds, all the Guardians' homelands are incredible to look at. You have Sand's workshop filled with Christmas wonder with elves and yetis as helpers. Easter Island is an underground rabbit hole with living eggs. The Two Fairies' Palace is this kingdom in the sky with hummingbirds. And Pidge's Lair is the dark abyss and presents some muted effects whenever people stop believing in the Guardians. The only place that's bland is this town that Jack visits from time to time because it's just an ordinary town. With the character animation, they fully display what they can do to present themselves like something out of a comic book. There's a lot of action scenes in this movie, especially its dramatic climax. And into keeping that sense of charm to the heroes of the film, it does give out some enchanting and fun moments like decorating eggs for Easter, having a snowball fight, and racing to collect the most teeth.
With the animation and charm to this movie, it gives us a sense of nostalgia on how much we believe these characters existed. It gives us a sense of fun and how much we celebrated the spirit of Christmas, Easter, the enjoyment of dreams, and looking back at our memories. And that's the beauty of this movie.
Rise of the Guardians is a DreamWorks anime film that deserves to be worth remembering. The story is fresh and magical, the characters are memorable, and the animation is beautiful with some great action scenes. I definitely recommend you go check this movie out. I actually prefer it as one of the DreamWorks sequels that we want to see. I know the movie was a flaw, but still, money doesn't matter because at least this movie does have some great quality to become a cinematic sequel. Seriously, DreamWorks, you gave us these pointless franchises. You should give us a franchise we actually want. I give Rise of the Guardians a B+.
And that was Winter Cyber Wonderland, and...
Aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, jeez, what do you want now?
You were supposed to review a bad Christmas special like you often do on your channel. I even have some recommended for you.
I can't. Winter Cyber Wonderland's over.
Oh, no, this isn't right. This is all about me. I deserve one last drink.
Well, joke's on you. I'm reviewing a wonderful movie from you next week. And besides, there were no terrible anime films this year.
Then I challenge you to review the worst movie of 2019, period.
Oh, no. Why?
Because I existed in that film before I was born.
But animation is in my field, and that movie is not animated.
But wasn't it originally supposed to be animated before it jumped into a live-action CGI movie?
Fine, I'll do it if you just go away.
Looks like I'm gonna die a happy man.
If that's what you want.
Eh?
Off with its head!
Oh, sweethearts.
Hello? I'm Times 2021st Son, and I'm here for my debut.
Quick question, do you have any plans? Like, good plans?
Well, I have one or two plans, but the rest I'm not sure, but I can try my best.
Well, it's better than nothing. I'm Mad Hatter Patrick, now if you'll excuse me, be safe, be kind, be responsible, work smarter, not harder, and let's try to make some improvements.
Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed this, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe me for a new review and other project every week. I'll see you soon.